So today we'll try to solve two complex problems which are given in previous GATE examination and how to solve those problems within less time. So without using the conventional procedure. So conventional procedure generally takes how much time? It takes almost more than half an hour or more than 45 minutes. Okay. So that is why now we'll try to solve the problem of Fourier series using properties. So the problem is find the Fourier series of the x of t. The x of t picture is given something like this. All of you see clearly, this is the picture of x of t. So it is a previous GATE problem. So I will try to draw the picture. It is a triangular function. The picture what has given is a triangular function. So see here clearly, it is something like this. So this is a triangular function he has given. It is periodic, okay, and has given simply this as t. So this has t by 2. So this will be minus t, whereas this is minus t by 2. And the value of this is from a to minus a. This is a and this is minus a. From a to minus a. Okay, so this is the question x of t what has given. So you have to solve this problem using the concepts of Fourier series. If you try to define the function over a period, you can define the function between 0 to t, or you can define the function between, if you try to define the function between 0 to t, then unfortunately the problem is here 0 to t, you have to write the expression of this line and also expression of this line. Two expressions you have to write which are not passing through origin. So it will take a lot of time to solve this problem, because which are not passing through origin means how you have to write y1 is equal to m1 x1 m1 x1 or you have to write like this, x1t is equal to m1t plus c1, x2t is equal to m2t plus c2. So x1t is equal to m1t plus c1, and similarly x2t is equal to m2t plus c2. So you have to calculate the values of x1t and x2t like that. But it takes a lot of time solving for the slope of m1, slope of m2 and the constants c1 and c2. So it just takes a lot of time. So I will try to go the same problem in a different methodology. That is what I try to do. I will try to find the differentiation. I will try to apply the differentiation property at last. I will try to apply the differentiation, because if I try to apply the differentiation, what will happen? The triangle will become square. And if you try to once again differentiate the square, you will get impulse. So different, what is the Fourier series of impulse? Already you have calculated, it is simply 1 by Ts. Okay, then finally you can apply the property. So that is the procedure what we try to do now. See here clearly. So I will try to make the differentiation of this picture. So let us, I will extend here itself and I will try to plot the differentiation of this. So differentiation of the triangle is the square. What is the height of square? Simply the slope value. Okay, understood? You make the differentiation of this is what you are getting only slope m1. differentiation of this, you'll get slope m2. So with the green color, I will try to write the slope of this line first of all. How can you find the slope of this line? Slope of this line is from here to here, what is the y change, and here to here, what is the x change, dy by dx. That is, the value is simply, what is the y change? What is the y change? A to minus a, and it is decreasing. So minus a minus a, so you are having 2a minus 2a divided by, what is the time? Simply here to here, t by 2. So answer is minus 4a by t. If it is a decreasing straight line, minus 4a by t. If it is increasing straight line, plus 4a by t. Very simple. So it is simply minus 4a by t. That is the slope of this line. This is 4a by t. That is the slope of this line. Minus 4a by t. This is the slope of this line. Similarly, this is 4a by t. This is the slope of this line, and so on. Understand the logic now? Now, what I try to do, I try to put the points here. This is minus t by 2, I will try to consider. And this is t by 2, I will try to consider. And this will be 3, I will try to consider. And this will be minus 3, I will try to consider. Okay, understand clearly? Now, I will, what is the differentiation of the triangle, what you are saying? Simply, differentiation of a straight line. You are getting it as simply slope. So, that slope I have to take. So, 0 to t by 2, you are getting a picture, something like this. I am drawing with the blue color. So, it is a minus 4a by t. Okay. T by 2 to t, it is plus 4a by t. Similarly, t like this. Minus t by 2 to 0, it is how much? Plus 4a by t. Getting a picture something like this. Minus t to minus t, it is a decreasing straight line, negative slope. You are having. Okay. I have to draw minus 4a by t. Okay. So, if I try to, you can join the discontinuities in signals and systems. Okay. You can join the discontinuities in signals and systems. So, you can join. So, you are having a perfect square you are getting, okay, understand clearly with differentiation of the triangle. So, this is what I have done. It is simply dx of t by dt, and this height is 4a by t. So, it swings between 4a by t and 4a by minus 4a by t. The square is maximum is 4a by t and minimum is minus 4a by t. Okay. So, that is the idea of this problem. Now, what I try to do, I will try to go for once again differentiation. Why? Because even finding the Fourier series for this is still difficult. It will take a lot of time. So, I will go for once again differentiation. See here, students, how I am planning this. Okay. See here clearly. So, this is d square x of t by dt square I am calculating. I am going with the pink color. Okay. So, this plot what I am doing, d square x of t by dt square. Okay. So, differentiation of these constants, you will get 0, nothing. Okay. So, this is 0. So, this is t by 2 and it is t. So, but noting these t by 2s minus t by 2s are very, very important in Fourier series. If you miss this logic, then the answer will be gone. So, you must be very much cautious in writing the timing values of the signals. Okay. So, now I am going ahead. So, now I will try to consider. So, however, the constant differentiation is 0, but you have a discontinuity. You have a discontinuity. Discontinuity differentiation, generally the differentiation of step is what? Impulse function. How will you get the differentiation? What is the amount of change in the step? That becomes the area under the impulse here. Once again, important point. There, what is the amount of slope that has become the step height? That has become the step height.
whatever the step change is there, that becomes the area under the impulse. The meaning is, here there is a step change at this point. Okay, there is a step change at this point. So step down jump or step up jump. If it is step up jump, you will get plus del of t. If you are getting step down jump, you will be getting minus del of t. Now see here. Here it is, what is the step change? Here it is minus plus 4a by t. It is minus 4a by t. So it is, change is how much? Always final minus initial. Final minus initial means it is simply 8a by t. So here you are getting a positive impulse, that is 8a by t. Understand clearly, students, how I am doing 8a by t. Similarly, here there is a step down jump. It is minus 4a by t final value. Initial value is 4a by t. So minus 4a by t, minus 4a by t, you will get minus 8a by t. We are getting this value, minus 8a by t. And here you will be getting something, t plus t by 2 plus 8a by t. Okay. Negative part, I will try to take a different color, not with the pink color. Okay, see here clearly. So, I will try to take the green color. I will take the brown color. Okay. Now, see here, green color I am taking. It is the value of t. You are having how much? Minus 8a by t. Even at 0 also, you have a down jump. So, here you will be getting minus 8a by t impulse. Okay. Here you are getting, once again, minus 8a by t. And see here clearly, what you are getting at t by 2, you are getting plus 8a by t. And here also you will be getting 8a by t. Minus t by 2, if you add, you will get this point. So don't worry, it is not required for me at this point of time. Why to waste my time? So why? Because I have got a period here itself. Okay, so that is clear. So now you have to evaluate the Fourier series of this picture. You have to evaluate the Fourier series of this picture. Once you got the Fourier series of this, then directly you can get the Fourier series of this, that is Cn quotient. Even you can get the Fourier series of this Cn value. Very clear. How will you get the Fourier series of this impulse train? What is the Fourier series? 1 by Ts, 1 by period. See here, this is the logic I want to do here. If you have an impulse train which is happening for 0 Ts, 2 Ts, 3 Ts, minus Ts, something like this, and so on and so on, the Fourier series quotient is what? 1 by Ts. So now I will try to separate the pink colors and the green colors. Very important. You have to make them separate and you can add the quotients. Okay. The green color lines, impulses, what is the Fourier series? Exactly, it is happening at 0. It is happening at t. It is happening at minus Understand very clearly. It is happening at t, it is happening at 0, it is happening at minus t. These green color lines are just inverse of these blue color lines. Why? Because it is happening at 0, it is happening at ts, 2ts, something like this. If the amplitude is a, it is actually a by ts. But here amplitude is how much? Minus 8a by t. Okay, amplitude is minus 8a by t. Divided by Ts. Ts is how much? The green color is happening for every t. So, the Fourier series of this green color is directly, I can write it as the quotient, I can write it as Cn quotient, or I will try to write it as Fourier series better. Fourier series, I will try to write it as simply minus 8a by t is the amplitude divided by what? this TS. What is TS? For every T it is happening. So that T, so totally you will get minus 8A by T square. Minus 8A by T square. Don't worry students, with the practice directly within seconds you will be able to write this solution. Don't worry, I am taking a little bit time here because you have to understand the concepts very clearly. But if you are good enough, you practice many problems, then with at a faster steps, okay, simply find the slope, draw the square, take the step change, get the impulse, write the Fourier series, very easy. Okay, so now similarly, now I want to get the Fourier series of the what you call it as the pink color impulses. Finally, I can add them. Linearity property I can apply. I can add the two Fourier series to get the overall Fourier series of d square x of t by dt square. That is my idea. So now, see here clearly, I am taking once again the pink color. But the pink color impulse, it is not happening at exactly zero. It is not happening at exactly zero. It is very clear. If it is happening at 0 TS, 2 TS, compulsory zero, you should find one impulse. Then only this formula holds good. But it is happening at a delay of T by 2. So here you have to apply one more property. There is a time shifting property of the Fourier series. So what is the time shifting property of the Fourier series for this pink color? What I am doing, see here, if this is the x of, you confuse with x, so I will try to take some another. So p of t quotient is tn, then p of t minus t naught quotient is tn e power minus j n omega naught t naught. Okay, if it is shifted by t naught, original quotient into e power minus j n omega naught, that shifted parameter t naught. Here, what is t naught? It is shifted by t by 2. The pink from 0th position, it is shifted by t by 2. So, the quotient of this Fourier series quotient of this is directly you can write it as, actually it is the ATA, actual quotient is how much? ATA by t divided by what is the period? What is the period here? The impulses are happening for every t. The period is t. So actually you have to get ATA by t divided by t. This is the quotient. That is, once again you will be getting ATA by t square. Very clear. It is ATA by t square. That's good. ATA by t square, but this pink color impulses are shifted by an amount of t by 2. They are shifted by an amount of simply t by 2. So t by 2 means e power minus j n omega naught. You can write it as t naught value how much? T divided by 2. So now you got the Fourier series of this pink, you got the Fourier series of this green. If you try to add these two Fourier series, then you will be getting the Fourier series of d square x of t by dt square. Once you are getting the Fourier of this d square x of t by dt square, what we have to do? We have to apply the differentiation property to get the Fourier series of dx of t by dt. Once you know dx of t by dt Fourier series, simply you will get the Fourier series of x of t. So simply by using the properties, very easily you can solve these problems without doing so many integrations, so many differentiations and remembering all those formulas. Okay, not required to solve these type of problems. So now I will try to add these two and I will try to check how much I am getting. So I am going in the next slide. Next slide, I will try to write the Fourier series of d square x of t by dt square Fourier series. I will try to write. So d square x of t by dt square Fourier series I will try to write. See here. So d square x of t by dt square Fourier series. It is combination of what and what? It is a combination of green and pink. So first I will try to take the pink one. So this is ATA by T square. So this I will try to still simplify. Why? Because in the place of omega naught, I can substitute 2 pi by T. Okay. If I substitute 2 pi by T, T, T getting cancelled, 2, 2 getting cancelled, you are getting e power minus j n pi. E power minus j n pi I am getting. Okay. So I will try to write that in the next slide. So this is 8a by t square e power minus j n pi, and I am adding the green color one. What is the green color one? It is simply minus 8a by t square. So I will try to take the green color for clarity. Minus 8a by t square. Okay. So I will try to simplify further. This is cos n pi minus j sin n pi. J sin n pi is 0. Sin n pi is 0. So we are having cos n pi. So cos n pi is simply 8a by t square. Okay, you can take common. Cos n pi is minus 1 whole power n minus 1. So logic, 8a by t square into minus 1 whole power n minus 1. That is the idea. So now what I try to do, if I try to consider n as even, if n is even, unfortunately the Fourier series quotient of dx square by dt, that is cn value, is becoming 0. Okay. So if n is even, let us split here these things. So n is even, then this quotient is becoming how much? This becomes a plus 1, minus 1 whole square, you are having plus 1, plus 1 minus 1, you are having the quotient it as 0, equal to 0. But if n is odd, what is the final value? So odd means minus 16a by t square. The answer is minus, odd means this is minus 1, this is minus 1, so minus 2, so minus 16a by t square. So this is the Fourier series quotient of simply d square x of t by d t square. And so logic, minus 16 a by t square. Now here, but you want what? Fourier quotient of what? X of t. See here clearly, if x of t quotient is cn, yet dx of t by dt quotient is what? Dx of t by dt quotient is what? J n omega naught cn. What is d square x of t by dt square quotient? J n omega naught whole square cn. Understood the logic? So now the Fourier quotient, for what you got this d square x of t by dt square. So now I will try to do this logic here. See here clearly. Now what I got? J, I am comparing this expression 1 and expression 2. Okay, what I got? J n omega naught whole square, J n omega naught whole square into Cn value is this quotient 16 a by t square when n is simply odd and the value is 0, however n is even. So finally, if n is even, even Cn will become 0. Cn is what? Actual quotient, what you want. Okay, so now J n omega naught square, this value. So Cn is equal to, understand clearly, Cn is equal to, what are you getting? Minus 16a by t square. Okay. J n omega naught. J n omega naught whole square. That's it. So if you try to solve this result, that is the final quotient Cn, that is minus 16a by
t square, j square is minus 1. So you have minus 1 again, n square, omega naught square is simply how much? 2 pi square. 2 pi by t square. 2 pi by t means 4 pi square and 1 more t square. So you try to cancel some of the terms here. So this is minus and this is minus. And this is t square here and t square here will be cancelled. Okay. And this 4 and this 4 is cancelled here. So finally you are getting the value of Cn as Cn is implies the value of Cn is equal to how much you are getting? Numerator is 4a by n square pi square. So it is simply 4a by n square pi square. This is the final quotient of Fourier series quotient of the original x of t triangular function what we have taken. What we have taken. So the answer is 4a by n square pi square. So however, I have followed this method. See here clearly. Once again, I will try to roughly explain you what I have done. But I have taken almost 20 minutes of time to solve this problem. But with practice, so I have to explain you. That is why I have taken this much time. If I want to do this, I can solve this within 2 minutes. How I will do? Simply, I will write the slopes. Once I write the slopes, then I will take this step. Then once I take the step, immediately I try to make differentiation, I will get impulses. So I know impulse train. So directly for this green, directly I can write within 2 seconds, 3 seconds, I can write it as simply a minus 8a by t whole divided by t. Similarly, this pink color, it is shifted of how much? T by 2. So that is why I will add e power minus n omega naught t by 2 separately. And original Fourier quotient is what? It is 8a by t by period. So 8a by t divided by period is t once again. So you are getting this logic. Okay. Here you can substitute omega naught simply 2 pi by t. And you can simplify this. So I got the Fourier series quotient of d square x of t by dc square even and odd. Cn, okay, even and odd. I got two values. So you know d square x of t by dt square quotient, then actually this is what jn omega naught square n cn. So what you have to do, you have to divide with jn omega naught square to get the value of cn x of t. So I have divided jn omega naught square. Okay, then I have substituted omega naught 2 pi by tt and I have solved here. So this expression is only for n is odd case, very important, and is 0 when n is simply even. So this is the thing you have to remember carefully. So while writing this, Cn is 4a by n square pi square. If n is odd, n square pi square if n is odd. Similarly, Cn is simply 0 when n is even. Okay. So like this, you have to solve the problems using the properties. So properties are very, very important in solving the Fourier series problem. Otherwise, if you go with the conventional procedure, if you try to write the equation of the straight lines, okay, x1t, x2t, and then solving them, so it takes a lot of time, almost 40 minutes, 45 minutes it will take. Okay, so hope you have gained thorough knowledge on this session. So if you really like the videos, you can subscribe to the channel. If you find any doubts, or if you want to give any feedback, you can give in the comment section below. If you want to follow the complete lectures, so you can register at the Octomy Academy. Thank you.